This week, I'll show you 5 tips for quick editing in Lightroom. I use Lightroom on a daily basis. If you haven't used it but are interested, click on the link below. This will take you to a 30-day free trial. Unless you have some of the earlier versions of Lightroom, you do have to pay a subscription every month. But I think it's well worth it. Lightroom and Photoshop work really well together, and I use them on a daily basis. If you haven't used Lightroom before and want a complete tutorial on the program, click on the eye in the corner or the link in the description to my Lightroom tutorial. When you're editing a lot of images in Lightroom, it can take a long time, but there are certain things that aren't that obvious that can speed up your workflow dramatically. So here are 5 things I do on a regular basis to save me so much time. No one really talks about this auto button, but I find sometimes you can hit it and it gets the image spot on. Other times you'll press it and it gets it way out. So it's a little bit random, but sometimes you can press it, tweak the settings, and then you'll get your image to where you want it to be a lot quicker than you normally would in just dragging individual sliders. Sometimes I'll be working on a job where I'll get groups of shots that have pretty much the same settings. I shoot in manual, and sometimes when I'm shooting with a flash, the settings will be exactly the same. In this instance, I'll edit the first image and then use sync settings to change all of the images in that group. I'll select the ones I want to change, keeping the first image as the selected one. Then I'll click on sync settings, sync all settings, and click OK. This will make sure that the settings are exactly the same from the first one to the last one that you selected. You may have to tweak some of the settings in each of these images, but it will speed up your workflow. If you shoot with a mirrorless camera, you'll know all too well about dust spots in your image. The spot removal tool is a great function to get rid of these dust spots. However, some of the dust spots are quite hard to see and they won't stand out until you've processed your image. Now you can set this to heal or clone. I normally have it on heal with quite a soft edge. However, it's sometimes really hard to see the dust spots clearly. So just click on this check mark at the bottom and the image will turn into a black and white negative. This then shows up the spots a lot more clearly and it makes it a lot faster to remove these dust spots. To increase the contrast just to the point of a complete range from pure black to pure white, hold down Alt and then click on the black or white sliders. This will then show you any parts that are under or overexposed. You can then get the most out of your image by pushing the blacks down until they are just touching pure black, and then pushing the white slider up until it's just touching pure white. This will quickly give you the most luminance range for your image, making it more contrasty but not losing any data. This will make sure that you're getting the most out of your image without clipping the highlights or crushing the shadows. Up until recently, if you wanted to mask off any part of your image, you'd have to use Photoshop. But now they have auto mask and range masking. This is nowhere near as good as Photoshop masking, but in certain circumstances it works really well. So first off, we'll look at auto mask. Click on the adjustment brush and then make sure auto mask is checked. This will then paint up to contrasting colors, but not beyond that line unless you really go over it. It makes it easier to select certain areas that you may want to change. So if I zoom in, you can see auto mask has painted up to this line, but not over it. If I unselect show selected mask overlay and make any changes, it will only change the land where I selected. With the gradient tool, select the area you want to change. Make the changes you want in this gradient area. You'll notice it makes changes to everything, darkening any mountains that protrude into the gradiated area. So go to Range Mask and select Luminance. Select Show Luminance Mask and then pull the left-hand tag up. This will lessen the effect the mask has on darker parts of your image. So when I unselect Show Luminance Mask, you can see it gives a much more natural look. And that's about it. Lightroom is quite a complex program and there's lots to learn in it. You may find that it takes ages to edit your photos, but with these 5 quick tips, you can speed up your workflow no end. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And for weekly tutorials, hints and tips in photography and videography, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next one.